Are you ready for the killer? Yeah. Are you ready for the killer?
Absolutely.
Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan ik niet pikken. Dat kan ik niet pikken, de jeuk. Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan ik niet pikken. Dat kan ik niet pikken, de jeuk. Is geen klappetje door, dat ken ik goed verstand. Dan rijd elke serieuze mengs al eens beoefde aan. Maar kom maar niet vertellen dat je heel de dag lang klapt. Wees hoe ver je schep geeft door dat we mee aan het ogen. En was het alleen was losse en een beetje tijdig en rust. Of het ook liggen vossen, schat, hoe ver ging dat gemust? Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk?
Now I'm removing our irrigation system because I'm going to cultivate this plot. And we're going to plant either Chinese kale or Bagyo Pechay or Pechay Bagyo.
Yes, because that was lettuce before.
Yeah. You do not plant anymore the same family as lettuce. The place where they were planted before, or you will get a lot of pests.
Yeah.
So what we do, because we constantly use our soil, it's very soft. So in cultivating, you first use a fork.
Yes.
What you do is, you put it in entirely. Just put it up like that.
Just to air it.
Yeah.
Because okay, for the cement under it.
Under here.
From the post. I must have seen that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I son. Just stay a little bit away from it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because there's this cement under it for the post that holds the roof up, you know?
Yeah. There's the foundation. So it's
you have a hard time to do that.
Yeah, but even in awkward position, it's very soft, as you see. So what this does is it aerates the soil because the micro and macroorganisms in the soil also needs oxygen.
Actually, you can easily push it in by hand only.
Yeah.
Yes. It's very soft. But you should go close enough to the corner tan.
Yeah.
So that it doesn't become hard later on.
Yeah.
So it maintains the same size of bed.
Yeah. So if you do this all the time and you use all the time your soil and you're doing your ecological farming, you don't need to rest your soil.
No, because the soil is alive. And the microorganisms they are in it. You keep the soil always fed with water, and you see, it might look dry on top, but it doesn't dry down.
Look,
you see,
here.
It does not dry down, huh?
That's because of our
drip system, and it goes down under. So, and the microorganisms they stay nicely alive there.
Yeah.
If you let it rest and it dries out, and so on, no, it's not good.
You only rest your soil if you're doing chemical farming or commercial farming.
Yeah.
All right.
This is one of our friends that pollinates our nice vegetables. It's a puyuk, or how you call that. But I think he's getting old. Yeah, he's getting old already. He doesn't move too much anymore. Mm-mm.
So I'm also aerating this part of the plot. Before, when Mama and Papa were still doing traditional old school organic farming, they relied greatly on compost. So all of our compost worms, the African night crawlers, were all at the compost pile or compost area. But because of our new system, which you can learn about in our upcoming fifth material, it's not yet out in the market, our compost worms migrated from our compost area to our plots. So you can see here, African night crawlers. Yeah, they're a bit shy.
But they're there.
Yeah. Hey, even here. Hey, you. So what we do now, because we don't rely 100% anymore on
compost.
Compost for us serves primarily as a texturizer of our
and to add trace elements.
Yeah, trace elements. Yeah. So what we do is, because when you don't have compost worms at your compost pile, the composition becomes very slow. So it takes a longer time. So what we do is, we don't really make the compost very ripe because all our compost worms are here. So we just feed them with compost and they do all the job or all the work here on our plot, giving our plants more nutrients or trace elements together with our new system, which you will learn about in our fifth upcoming material called Aquaterra Integrated Farming, Ecological Farming.
Yes.
All right. What you doing?
Well, I'm working in the compost into the soil. Actually, I'm through already.
Yeah.
You're a little bit late with your video.
Yeah.
But that's okay. Because now I will rake it, so that will be nice and flat. And
yeah.
Can make the bigger parts a little bit smaller.
Yeah.
Actually, you see, we did not even put water, despite moisture.
Yeah.
So it's not good. It's not bad. I mean,
it's not. Actually, it's very good.
Yes.
Yeah. So that
the macro life in the soil also needs moisture, water, just like it needs oxygen. That's why we work it.
Yeah.
So you will have a good.
Yeah. And when we transplant our seedlings here, they're not going to have a very hard time because the soil is already moisture.
Yes.
All right.
So I will get a rake.
Yeah. So I stand corrected. The soil is not moisture, but moist.
<It's>
grammatically incorrect.
Yeah.
So Papa is now raking it to make the soil finer. That's how soft our soil is. Just use a rake on the big bits on it or big particles and they just crumble.
It's also because they're moist.
Moist. They are not moisture, but moist.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Actually, English is not really our mother language, so we're doing our best.
You're doing alright.
Alright.
What's your mother language, huh?
I was born here in the Philippines, so I would say it's Filipino. Mm-hmm. But you came from Belgium, and your mother language is Flemish or Dutch.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm caught somewhere in between.
Well, you know a little Dutch, your money.
Yeah. All right. So I'm now filling up the tanks, the fish tanks here at our aquaponics area. We're doing it for free. You know why? Because we are using rainwater from that tank over there. Can follow the hose.
Yeah. This is the water that comes from the gutter.
Yeah.
You can see the gutter here.
Water.
Comes from the roof.
Yeah, from the roof. Actually, it's very important to have a good water supply. If it's for free, so much the better. So, when you're culturing fish, especially when you're doing commercial culturing of fish, they need to change the water, or 20% of the tank water, because when you're growing fish, the number one enemy that hinders the growth of fish is the ammonia level in the water. But here at our aquaponics area, when you're doing aquaponics, it's ideal to grow fish. Why? Because the plant beds, when you pump the water from the fish tank to the plant beds, microorganisms and macroorganisms inside the plant beds convert the ammonia into useful nitrates and nitrites for the plants. So when it goes back to the fish tank, it's practically filtered, but not 100%, but it's to a level that makes the fish grow really fast. Not organically, 5 months.
Yeah, it's doing well, yes. Yeah,
because here at the aquaponics area, this is where we grow our fish. And they grow about tilapia, plapla size. And it's about, some would be half a kilo for one fish. Some almost half a kilo, so that's not bad. So make sure you do not add a lot of new water. Why? Because it takes out the oxygen from the water. If you put a lot of new water in your tank, you would see your fish at the surface gasping for air.
Or maybe you have to let it really splash.
Yeah, or let it splash, but still, it's not aerated that much, especially when it's standing still.
Yeah, water, it comes from a tank like that, yes.
So be careful not to add a lot of new water. 10 to 20% of the tank. We don't usually do it here because we only do it because it was so hot and the water evaporated, as well as the plants, they also take water.
Yeah, and they
also absorb water.
Yeah, so they transpire also water.
From time to time, we check the tanks, make sure the water level is okay, and if it's not, we add water. And luckily for us, we have rainwater because it was raining hard last night.
Yeah, and that's so what we do. We maximize nature.
Yeah, and all with gravity. And I think it's also going to rain again.
Probably it looks like.
Yeah, and if you follow me here.
Yeah, I'll follow you.
We're going to have mangoes.
Oh, but so hopefully they will not be
eaten by
fruit flies, and they will not be disturbed by the strong rains.
Yeah, so it looks promising.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it took a long time. For them to give fruits again. Don't know why, because I think it's with the weather.
It's because it can be very windy here.
Yeah, windy and a bit cooler, because mangoes really thrive in warm areas, especially in Batangas, where they have a lot of mango plantations and a lot of parts in the Philippines. But if you are free on a Saturday, maybe in the future when these are ripe already, you can get a taste of pure organic mangoes without the spray.
Of course.
In plantations, they spray it a lot.
Oh, yes.
To get rid of the fruit flies.
And to have it flower.
Yeah. All right. So we have here our new duckweed. Hopefully, there will be no more small freshwater snails, because they kill duckweed. You will see an infestation if you see small, like shell-like things not breaking the surface of the surface tension of the water. They go upside down, the snails, and they eat the roots of the duckweed. And I think there's a small fingerling here inside, but it's not going to eat the duckweed. It's too small.
Yeah, it became already more, no?
Yeah.
It's multiplying already.
Yeah, it's multiplying. And it's starting to rain again. And actually, we did a lot today. Here we have our new batch of pickling cucumbers. Jalapenos are starting to flower. See here? The
are already starting to flower. That's from ratooning. And we're going to have a lot of jalapenos again. The bok choys are doing good. That's lettuce. Red rapids. Papa transplanted new celery. They're still small. We just put net over it so that the birds won't think that they had to harvest it themselves. We have here newly transplanted, this is the plot that we were working on this morning. Newly transplanted Chinese pet chai or Baguio pet chai. We have here newly transplanted Chinese kale. We also have a different variety of kale here. Pa, what kind of kale is this? Yeah. What kind of kale?
The kale that
breaks one?
Toscana.
Yeah,
and it's a different kind of kale.
Yeah.
It's a different kind of kale. Kind of kale.
Yeah, it's the traditional kind. And I think, wow, we're still trying it out.
Yeah, it's doing well.
Yeah, it's doing well. And you can see the benefits of having a roof over your planting area. It's not going to get destroyed or washed away by strong rains. And what do we have here? We have really nice romaine lettuce. What a beauty! And now we transplanted new, because here it was planted, we planted different kinds of basils. So we, this one is a bit withered from transplanting, but we hope it's going to bounce back. So hopefully we would see you guys at the FTI or the Aani weekend market this Saturday. And here are our old jalapenos having fruits again. See the benefit of ratooning your crops. So till the next episode.